Ngayon, para silang langis at tubig. Parang hindi mo may pagtatabi ng hindi nagbabangayan. But in several critical moments in history, they were the closest we've ever had to political soulmates. Let's take a look at opposite sides of the political fence. The ruling PDP Laban and the Liberal Party. Their internal convulsions and what these tell us about the problem of political parties in this country.
The PDP Laban is the party in power, or at least on paper. The party chairman is the President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. But at this point, that is the only thing that is clear. Last July, the party ejected its acting president, who wants to run for the country's highest post in 2022. The faction of new party president Alfonso Cusi wants Duterte to run for vice president and choose his own standard bearer. Now that, for any party, is an amazing leap of faith. And the standard bearer may just be the president's daughter, who is not a party member. In all these, Duterte seems above it all, even taking pot shots at the party that now kisses his feet.
Tong parting PDP was asleep for 100 years. It only woke up during the election and in a run for the presidency under the ticket.
PDP Laban's executive director, Ronmun Sayak, is identified with Senator Manny Pacquiao's camp. He has been with the party for 12 years. He saw and laments how political ambitions had crept into their ideals.
We believe that there's a small group inside the PDP Laban who just entered the party recently when President Duterte became president. And we believe that this handful of political appointees and elected officials want to so-called continue their stay in power or to extend by endorsing a candidate who is not a member of the PDP Laban.
But Munsayak says the president needs to be reminded that he is not the party.
He would just like to remind our party chairman, President Digong, whom he has been part of the PDP Laban ever since, that the PDP Laban was founded against tyranny, against one family rule, and the PDP Laban is beyond one administration.
Political science professor Julio Tihangki says Duterte has shown no interest in his own political party and no qualms of undermining it, which could be both good and bad.
One of the consequences of Duterte's populist presidency is the further weakening of the party system. The past presidents were involved, you know, at least, or were interested in the running of the affairs of the administration party. This president was not interested. No? He left it to his allies and to his close allies. And since hindi interesado ang presidente doon, bakit pa sasama itong mga politiko sa administration party? Bumaba yung value ng administration party sa mata ng mga politiko.
But here's the thing. Tihangki sees the pendulum swinging to the other side, reinforcing the message that political parties are not important and political personalities are. To understand this, let's take a look at the other dilawan, the Liberal Party.
Yung umpisa kasi LPNP, wala masyadong pagkakaiba. When Marcos established martial law, doon nagkaroon ng karakter ang LP eh. It was the party that was against martial law.
In 1978, LP stalwarts Ninoy Aquino and Lorenzo Tañada organized a new party, Lakas ng Bayan or Laban. Then in 1983, Laban merges with what Bagilat describes as its ideological brother, Aquilino Pimentel's Partido Democratico Pilipino. The PDP Laban was born. The PDP Laban formed the core of the anti-Marcos movement, a movement built on the ideals of human rights and democratic principles. And it would be a movement identified with the color yellow. His entire army
was turned against him. Ang first president na inailuklok ng PDP Laban is si President Cory Aquino.
Fortunes changed after the victory in EDSA. The 1987 Constitution established a multi-party system that started a free-for-all. By the time the 1992 elections came around, there were already 7 political parties gunning for Malacañang. Clearly, there was something wrong with the system.
Politicians now search for a viable presidential candidate rather than a viable political party. So the emphasis really in every electoral cycle is the search for a winnable personality rather than a workable platform for the future of the country.
The two parties reverted to their pre-EDSA reformist roles, serving as opposition voices. During GMA's time, the political opposition tried but failed to pass a law to finally reform the political party system. The Political Party Development Act penalizes turncoatism o yung pagbabalimbing. This means no switching of parties 8 months after elections. Another version only allows party switching 6 months before the end of a term in office. The idea is that you choose a political party because you believe in it and not because you can win with it.
Pundits would call them Volkswagen or Jeepney parties. Mapagkakasya mo raw kasi ang mga membro ng mga partidong ito sa isang Volkswagen at meron ka pa rin espasyo.
In other countries, if you switch parties, no, you lose your seat. That's the essence of the fact that you were elected.
Mas importante is the anti-turncoatism provision. If you have politicians that stay with the party because of regulations, then more or less malalaman ng tao, ito palang pagkakaiba ng mga political parties. Then they get rooted in the ideology, they get rooted in the platform of governance.
The other controversial provision of the measure, state subsidy for political parties. Yes, it does seem counterintuitive. If we blame politicians for our lot in life, then why should taxpayers spend for them? But it boils down to leveling the playing field for both big and small parties. The idea has taken root in almost all major democracies. These countries give state subsidies to political parties in various forms, from actual funding to tax credits. The idea is that state subsidies reduce political corruption, because candidates are not beholden to their campaign contributors. But this may be a tough sell for Filipinos.
For as long as we remain personality-oriented, no amount of subsidy can really strengthen the political party system. You first have to show that political parties do work. Kasi otherwise, di magsusulputan yung mga political parties na wala naman talagang itinutulak na agenda focused on certain political personal or even certain political dynasties and big business.
With GMA's ratings dropping abysmally in her last year, the opposition came the closest to passing these politically unpopular laws. But when the Liberals took over Malacanang, curiously, the bill was forgotten. In fact, it was the LP's turn to take in turncoats. From 20 congressmen in 2009, the Liberals in Congress grew to 117 in 2016. The party had become the creature it tried to suppress.
I remember having a discussion with some Liberals, no, na they were also questioning bakit hindi natin itinutulak ito, samantalang matingkad yata, no, during GMA's time, no, I was still governor at times, so hindi ko alam yung nangyari sa House, pero matingkad yung political party reform bill as one of the main pillars of the legislative agenda of the Liberal Party. But yung naging administration o ruling party na yung Liberal Party, medyo hindi na napag-usapan, admittedly, hindi nga naisama doon sa priority. No?
Maliwanag naman kay Pinoy kasi na kailangan yung reforms. Pero ang problem na nung panahon niya, ang lumilitaw, they don't want to go into it na sila yung tatamaan. Kaya they went through the motion.
Ang partido, pwedeng tumindig sa prinsipyo pag ito'y wala sa kapangyarihan. No? Ang problema, pag ito'y nakaupo na uli sa poder, no, para mag-survive ka, kailangan din may mga calculations ka at may cost-benefit analysis ka.
Bagilat argues that there was a need to preserve political capital for other reform programs in the party agenda. The first half of Aquino's term included the passage of sin taxes and the reproductive health bill.
Especially si Pinoy, that's how he strategized it. Yung kanyang political capital, at alam niya sa pagpasa ng isang difficult agenda sa Kongreso, nababawasan yung political agenda na yon.
And like all ruling parties, LP was working on the assumption that it would stay in Malacañang after the next polls.
For our main challenge, no, yung during the first years of Pinoy, was you'd like to push your platform, no, now that you are in the ruling party, but at the same time also busy consolidating your power, trying to get a super coalition both houses. So medyo nakalimutan tuloy itong ibang mga bills.
They think na hihina yung standing ng ruling party kapag itulak nila ng gusto itong political party reform bill, baka tamaan yung kanilang prospect to retain the power.
This happened again in 2016. Duterte swept the presidential elections for the PDP Laban. And again, the political butterflies in Congress flitted about. Only 3 PDP Laban congressmen were elected in 2016. But in the span of a few months, those lonely 3 would turn into the biggest supermajority Congress has ever seen. Except for 7 congressmen, almost all 300 congressmen joined the ruling supermajority. These included most of the members of the Liberal Party in Congress. Tihanki thinks PDP Laban will also inherit the Liberal Party's problems.
PDP Laban actually, to its credit, especially to the old guard, meron talaga yung itinutulak na ideology. Before Digong, yung federalism was already their main agenda. No? Niyakap na lang yan ni Digong nung siya yung nanalo bilang presidente. Pero bigla na lang nakalimutan na yata.
No? After siya nanalo, binuo niya kagad yung constitutional reform na organization sa DILG.
Yeah, commission.
Akala ko tuloy-tuloy na yun kasi mabigat yung issue eh. Federalism, etc. Pero sa gitna nun, tumikrop din.
And what had historically been the party's defining stance on key issues like human rights has since morphed into Duterte's own version of human rights.
So that my orders to you, if you see them walking around, kindly shoot them dead. We would be happy.
But the PDP Laban is beyond one man, beyond President Digong. When he speaks about human rights, minsan nagbibiro siya, minsan hindi na natin alam. Pero we believe that he's not speaking as a PDP Laban.
PDP Laban is another victim of their own failure, no? In the same way that the Liberal Party was a victim of their own failure. Because the Liberal Party ran on a platform of reforming the system, and yet they did not pass the essential laws that should have addressed these political issues, like the ban on political dynasty, the ban on party switching, the party development law, freedom of information, and all.
Tihanki points out the people who make up the president's supermajority now are the same people who made up the ruling majority in all the other previous congresses. In other words, the names haven't really changed, only the parties. So their loyalties will only go as far as it guarantees their winnability in next year's elections. In the meantime, Munsiak says the old guards of the PDP Laban may turn to an old and now awkward ally.
Sabi nila, Sir Ron, baka you would want to explore rekindling yung alliance with the Liberal Party kasi ito yung parang ideological brothers namin eh. So we are open to rekindling that alliance. We would want to look at the ideologies of a party first rather than yung political.
Only a few politicians really ran and won under PDP Laban in the previous election. And that's the reason why you have other parties that are aligned with the administration that fielded its own candidates and won. No? And that's also the reason why a regional party, which is not really the national administration party, is challenging the so-called national administration party. No? In this case, it's Ugpong.
In the end, Munsiak says the party will lose members because of the ongoing rift. But for a party that helped restore Philippine democracy, there are more important things that they cannot afford to lose.
When Secretary Harry Roque said na pag umalis si President Duterte, magiging GP size ulit na lang ang PDP Laban. And kami naman, we don't take any offense kasi sanay ho kami, buti naging GP ho kami dahil tricycle lang kami. Pero at least yung nakasakay sa tricycle ngayon, at least ngayon nakasakay sa GP ngayon, eh puro nagkakaintindihan kami, pare-pares kami ng mga pinaglalaban, pare-pares kami ng mga prinsipyo na sinusunod.